goodness of Almighty. Welcome to NIMS Service School. I am Ashley Vishash, an assistant teacher of mathematics in National Ideal English Version School, Boarding Ship. Today I am going to take a math class for the student of class 5. So my student, let us start our class. The student, today is our lesson number 16 of Annual Jump. And my student, there is no SW today. Our today's topic's name, exercise 12. The name of this topic chapter is, the name of this chapter is Time. Okay. From this chapter, we shall do basic discussion. Okay. And from exercise 12, we shall solve 1, 2 and 3 as your CW. That is no SW today. So my dear student, let us start our class. Here you go. Okay. Some important short questions are there. Okay. So number 1. How many months are there in Bangla year or Bangla calendar? Year or Bangla calendar. I repeat, how many months are there in Bangla year or Bangla calendar? And another word, what are these? That means, what are the name of that month? My dear students, there are 12 months in Bangla year or Bangla calendar. I repeat, there are 12 months in Bangla year. Okay. They are Boishak, Joishko, Ashar, Shravan, Bhadra, Ashwin, Kartik, Bhagrat, Posh, Magh, Phalgun, and Chinese student. I repeat, Boishak, Joishko, Ashar, Shravan, Bhadra, Ashwin, Kartik, Bhagrat, Posh, Magh, Phalgun, and Chaitra. Now, my dear student, please notice how many days are there in every month. Notice, first 5 months. First 5 months. That means from Boishakh to Bhadra, each month contains 31 days. I repeat, each month contains 31 days. That means Boishakh has 31 days. Joshto has 31 days. Ashar has 31 days. Shravan has 31 days. Bhadra has 31 days. And rest of the months are consist of 30 days. That means Ashwin 30 days, Kartik 30 days, Bhagrat 30 days, Posh 30 days, Magh 30 days, Phalgun 30 days, Chaitra 30 days. I hope you have understood. If I ask you a question, how many months are there in Bhadra? We know from 1 to 5 months, each month contains 31 days. So we can easily answer that Bhadra has 31 days. If I ask you another question, how many days are there in the month of Chaitra? You can easily answer that Chaitra has 30 days. I hope you have understood. Now, my dear student, question number 2. How many months are there in English year or English calendar? Okay. And what are they? We know the answer was from our childhood we learned this question. Okay. So there are 12 months in English year. There are 12 months in English year or English calendar. They are January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. Okay, I repeat, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. I hope you have understood. My dear student, please notice, February is the month which contains 21 days. I repeat, February is the month which contains 21 days. And notice, April, June, September, November. These 4 months contain 30 days. I repeat, February is the month which contains 20 days. 28 days, sorry. February is the month which contains 28 days. And April, June, September and November are the month which contains 30 days of this month. So April has 31 days. April has 30 days. June has 30 days. September has 30 days. November has 30 days. And rest of the month, that means January, March, May, July, August, October, November, October and December are the months, each of them contains 31. So we can easily answer of any questions. Okay. if I ask you a question, how many days are there in December? December has 31. How many days are there in February? February has 28 days. How many days are there in May? May has 31. How many days are there in September? September has 30 days. I hope you have understood. So question number 1 done, 2 done. Now we shall learn question number 3. What do you mean by leap year? What do you mean by leap year? So generally we know that every year contains 365 days. But a year which contains 366 days, then that year is called leap year. I hope you have understood. Generally we know every year has 365 days, but a year which contains 366 days is called leap year. Okay. So how can we confirm if a year is leap year or not? If the year is divisible by 4, then we can easily say that year is leap year. I repeat, if the year is divisible by 4, then we can easily confirm that year is leap year. On the other hand, if the year contains 0 and 1's place, then 1's place and 10's place, if the year contains 10's place and 1's place is 0, and that year will be, that year will be leap year if they divisible by 400. If they divisible by 400. So then you can learn only this one. A year which is divisible by 4, then that year is leap year. I hope you have understood. Okay, my student. Now question number 4. What do you mean by decade? A period of 10 consecutive years is a decade. A period of 10 consecutive years is a decade. What do you mean by era? A period of 12 consecutive years is an era. What do you mean by century? A period of 100 consecutive years is a century. So this is consecutive. What do you mean by consecutive? A period of 10 consecutive years is called decade. That means consecutive means 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 35, 36, 37, 38, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 35, 36, 37, 38, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 35, 36, 37, 38, 9, 10, 1, 3, 2, committed. 4, 5, committed. Then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, here 10 year and here also 10. But this has 2 and 5 is committed. So, these are not continuous. Okay. So, this is consecutive now. So, these consecutive years make it ticket. Okay, that means a period of 10 consecutive years is an era, occupied by era. A period of 12 consecutive years is an era. What do you mean by this? A period of 100 years is an era. Stabun is the fourth month of Bangladesh. So Stabun has how many days? Stabun has 30 months. So here we write. Eighth month of Bangladesh. So it has 30 days. F 30 days. Then Choitro. Choitro is the last month of Bangla calendar. So we can say Choitro has 30 days. Okay. Then 5 number April. April is the month which has 30 days. April has 30 days. 6 number July. July has how many days? July has 31 days. 1 day. August. August has 31 days. And the last number, 8 number. December. December has how many days? December has 31. Okay, I hope you have understood by the student. This is the answer of question number 1. Next, question number 2. We have already written question number 2 on the board. What is the date that is 20 days after? What is the date that is 20 days? What is the date that is 20 days after Vaishakh 25? Vaishakh 25. What is the date that is 20 days after Vaishakh 25? Okay. So my dear students, how can we answer such type of question? So please notice the board. Okay. So at first we do addition. At first we do addition with this 25. 25 with this 20. Okay. So here we write 25 plus 20. Okay, my dear student, 25 plus 20. Okay, Vaishakh has how many days? Vaishakh has 31 days. And that 31 is subtracted from this total number. So we know if we add 25 with 20, then the summation will be greater than 31. So we subtract here. Okay, now we do subtraction. 5 and 45 minus 31. If we subtract, then we get 1, 4 and 40. So 31. Vaishakh has 31 days. So 31 days has completed. Next month of Vaishakh is Joshna. So 14 Joshna is the required answer. I hope you have understood. This is the answer of question number 1 of 2. So this is done. Next, we shall solve question number 2. What is the date that is 49 days after June 25? After June 25. Okay. Similar as question number 1. So first of all, June 25, that means 25 is added with this 14 days. Okay. Now my dear student, notice June is the month which contains 30 days. So we subtract 30. Because we know when do addition is smart, we get that 30. So now we do addition 9 and 4. If we add 5, if we add, then we get 14. Getting on 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7, 74 minus 30. That means if we subtract, then we get 4 and 44. Now my dear student, 44. So June has already completed. So in this case, this is July. July has how many days? July has 31 days. So 44 is greater than 31. Now we subtract that 31. Okay. So give a side note, July has 31 days. Now we subtract and we get 3, 13, August, because July has already completed. So 30 days is fall in the month of August. So here 13th August is done. Okay, enough and done. Next enough. When day 3 is Wednesday, what day of week is May 31? Okay, my dear student, how can we answer such type of question? My dear student, please don't. At first we subtract this day from that, that is May 31. We subtract May 3 from May 30. Now we subtract 31 minus 3. Okay. If we subtract, then we get 28. Now, my dear student, we divide this 28 by 7. Why 7? Because we know if week has how many days? If week has 7. We subtract 7. 28. If we divide 28 by 7, then we get 7 for that. 28. That means 0. So now, May 3 is 12. May 3 is 12. So we add Tuesday with, so we add this 0 with Tuesday. That means 0. So Tuesday plus 0, that means 20. And the answer is 20. Dear student, when we do division of this number by 7, we get a remainder which is 0. Then we do addition 0 with Tuesday, then we get 20. But if we get remainder 1 here, then Tuesday added with 1, that is Tuesday, and 1 day is added, that is Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. So the answer will be Wednesday. So this is the answer of question number 3. Then question number 4. Notice, when October 1 is Saturday, what day of week is October 31? So my question first is subtract 31 minus 1, that means 30. Now we divide this 30 by 7. Okay, so 7 4 is 28 and divide by 2. These 2 days is added with this Saturday. That means this is DURDAY plus 2. And what will be after 2 days of Saturday? The answer will be Saturday, Sunday, Monday. So Monday is the required answer. My next student, question number 2, done. Next, we shall solve question number 3. Question number 3 is, how many days were there in February of the following year? My next student, we have already learned leap year. A year which contains 366 days is called leap year. But generally we know that A year contains 365 days. A day is increased in a leap year, but that day is increased in the month of February. That is, in a leap year, February contains not 28 days, it will be 29 days. So if the year is leap year, then we can easily say that the February has 29 days. But if the year is not leap year, then we can say that year February has only 28 days. So first of all, we take this year is leap year or not. So how can we divide this number by 4? If we divide this 4 and the number is divisible by 4, then that year must be a leap year. So we want here 1200. So we divide 1200 by 4 first. 3 4 jar 12. And here 0, 4 0 jar 0, 0, 4 0 jar 0. So 1200 is divided by 4, so it is leap year. Very right. 1200 is was a leap year. Was a leap year. So we can say, so February in 1200 had 29 days. So here answer. I hope you have understood. So what done? Next we shall solve the question number. Here 1690. At first we check the number is divisible by 4 or not. 1692. So we divide this number by 4. In 16, 4 goes in 4 times. 4 for the 16. Subtract 0 and here 9 is left. In 9, 4 goes in 2 times 4 to the 8. Subtract 1 and 2 is placed here. In 12, 4 goes in 3 times. That means 4 to the 12. And subtract and we get 0. That means 1692 is divisible by 4. So this here is a DP. So we can say 1692 was a leap year. So February 8, 1692 had 29. Answer 29. My student, I hope you have understood question number 2 of 3. Then our last question of our class. Here you know this. The year is 2010. So at first we take 2010 is divisible by 4 or not. 2004 divisor and 2010 is divided. In 24 goes in 5 times. 5 4 are 20. Subtract at 0, 1 is placed here. In on 4 goes in 0 times 4, 0 the 0. Then 1 and this 0 is placed here. In 10 4 goes in 2 times 4 to the 8. And 2 is remainder. 2 is smaller than 2. So my student wrote in 2010. Not divisible by this year was not a leap year. So 2010 was not a leap year. So February 8, 2010 had 28 days. So answer is 28 days. My dear student, there is no SW. I hope you have understood my today's lecture. Keep practicing at home. Abide by your parents. See you soon. Till then, assalamu alaikum.